Hello students, in today's video we will be seeing about the second part of the chapter Japan and Brazil through a traveler's eye by George Mikes. Before going into the video, if anyone is seeing the channel for the first time or if you have not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe and share it with your friends, and also click the bell button to receive notifications whenever I upload new videos. So without wasting time, let us get into the video. So in the last video, we have seen about the manners or Japanese manners. So in today's video, we are going to see about traffic in Brazil. So here the author says about traffic in Brazil. So let us see what does the author say. Nobody hurries in Brazil. That is, nobody is in a rush in Brazil. Okay, no one hurries or no one is in a rush in Brazil. It does not really matter whether you reach your destination an hour too soon, a day late, or not at all. It does not matter. That means it does not matter. That is, the people in Brazil does not bother if they reach a place an hour too soon. If they reach a place soon, 1 hour soon, if they reach also, it does not matter. A day late, if they reach a place 1 day late also, they don't bother. Or not at all, if they don't reach at all also, it does not matter to the people of Brazil. That is how the people of Brazil are. The gray pavement in the streets of Copacabana are often decorated with beautiful black mosaics. So now the gray pavements means like the footpaths. Okay, pavements means it is like the footpaths. It is in the streets of Copacabana, it is a place, are often decorated with beautiful black mosaics. Okay, the streets of footpath are very beautiful, and it is said that they are decorated with black mosaics. You know what are mosaics? Those are simple patterns using small pieces of stones. Small pieces of stones are kept together and patterns are made. So that is how the pavements or footpaths are decorated. It is decorated using black mosaics. That is a unique type of decoration. That is a special style of decoration. So in Brazil, nobody hurries. That is, there is no rush in Brazil. It does not really matter whether you reach your destination an hour too soon, a day late, or not at all. And the footpath or the gray pavement in the street of Copacabana are often decorated with beautiful black mosaics, which is a special or unique type of decoration. So that was how the pavement of Brazil was decorated. Now let us move on to the next sentence. In the next sentence, the author says, only a people alive to beauty in their surroundings and who have plenty of time for contemplation during their meditative ambulatory exercises would take the trouble to decorate the pavements they walk on. Now the author is telling, everyone does not decorate their footpaths or the pavements. Only a people alive to beauty in their surroundings, that is, only people who are interested in beauty of their surroundings, then anyone who has plenty of time, those who have plenty of time for contemplation. Contemplation means they have enough and more time to look around or look thoughtful for a long time during their meditative ambulatory exercises. So if you have plenty of time during your meditative time, or if you have plenty of time during your ambulatory exercises, or when you are walking, if you have, usually footpaths are used for walking, for if you have a lot of free time, or if you enjoy, or if you are interested in beauty, only such people will have time, or they will only take trouble to decorate the pavements they walk on. That means he is telling that the people of Brazil are interested in beauty, or they have plenty of time to take care of the places even they walk on. That is why they decorate their footpaths. That is what the author is telling. So the next paragraph, however, as soon as these easygoing, leisurely characters get a steering wheel in their hands. So now, till now, it is said that the people of Brazil are very easygoing or leisurely. That is, they have enough and more time to do meditation. They have enough and more time to do walking. They are interested in beauty. They are very easygoing and they are leisurely. Till now, the author said like that. However, what he said, however, these easygoing or these relaxed people, they get a steering wheel in their hands. Once they get a steering wheel, that is, once they are going to drive a vehicle, steering wheel in their hands, no speed is fast enough for them. No speed is fast enough. That means how much ever speed is there, it is not enough for them. No speed is fast enough for them. You would then be inclined to believe that gaining a tenth of a second is a matter of grave importance for all of them, all time. That time, you will be forced to believe that, you will be inclined to believe, that means you will be forced to believe that for the people of Brazil, gaining a tenth of a second, that is 1/10 of a second also, is very important for them. Very important. 1/10 of a second is also very important. That much fast they drive vehicles. That is what the author is meaning. He is telling that as soon as these easygoing or relaxed, leisurely people get a steering wheel in their hands, no speed is fast enough for them. That is, how much ever speed they drive, it is not enough. And you will be forced to believe that for them, even 1/10 of a second is so much important, that is serious importance for all of them, all time. So that is what is explained in this paragraph. Now let us move on. Now here the author says, motor cars are extremely expensive in Brazil. Okay, so the speciality of Brazil is that motor cars are extremely expensive. They are very costly in Brazil. Import duties being crippling and murderous. Why are they very expensive? Because import duties, that is the taxes, are crippling. That is, are so high that it causes problems. They cause problems, crippling and murderous. It is very dangerous. That much high the import duties are, and that is why motor cars are very expensive. Only a few other poorer South American states are in worse position in this respect. Only some other South American states are in worse position in this regard, in the cost of motor cars. Other than Brazil, only some other poorer South American states are worse, or they are in a bad position. Complaints are universal means people all over are having complaints about this import duties. Hardly anyone can afford a car. That is, very less people can afford means have enough money. Very less people have enough money to buy a car. Okay, hardly anyone can afford a car. That means very less people have enough money to buy a car. Yet this only means that the number of motor vehicles is growing by leaps and bounds. After having said all these, the author is telling that even though all these issues are there, the number of motor vehicles is growing by leaps and bounds. That is, the number of motor vehicles is increasing very quickly. The number of motor vehicles are increasing by leaps and bounds means the number of motor vehicles are increasing very quickly. Okay, it is increasing very quickly, and bounds means in large amount. Okay, in large amount it is increasing very quickly. almost as if cards were distributed free of charge to all and sundry. See, the number of cards are increasing by leaps and bounds. It looks like cards are distributed free. That is, it looks like everyone is getting cards for free. That much the number of cards are increasing free of charge to all and sundry. To all and sundry means everyone. Okay, everyone. Everyone is getting cars free. Like that, the number of cars are increasing. And because of all these issues, because the number of cars are increasing, what is the problem? Who is facing the problem? It is said that pedestrians' life is becoming more hazardous every day. Pedestrians, who are pedestrians? Pedestrians are those who walk. That is a person who are the people who are walking. People who are walking, they are not using vehicles. Those are pedestrians on the road. People who are using vehicles also will be there, and those who are walking also will be there. So when the number of cars are increasing so much, the condition of this pedestrians, that is the condition of people who are walking, that becomes hazardous. Hazardous means that becomes very risky. Okay, when number of vehicles are more, the people who are walking, their condition becomes risky. It is not that drivers do not care about pedestrians. See, it is not that drivers do not care about pedestrians. What does drivers do? The trouble is that they do care about them. They are in fact on the lookout for them. That is, drivers do care about them. Okay, they take care of pedestrians. But it is in fact said that these drivers are on the look out for them. That is, it is just like they are searching for them. They are searching for pedestrians. Why? As soon as a driver notices a pedestrian step off the pavement, that is, as soon as this driver see a pedestrian come onto the road, he regards him as a fair game. That is, as soon as he see a person coming onto the road, he consider him as a target. And what he does? He takes aim and accelerates. So if a person is standing here, if a vehicle is coming from here, as soon as this driver sees this pedestrian, he takes aim and he accelerates. That is, he drives fastly and come to this person. Drives fast and come to this person. He takes aim and accelerates. That means you take aim on the pedestrian and he pushes the accelerator. So that is how drivers take care of pedestrians. So it is like a sarcasm he is telling, George Mikes is telling, that it is not that drivers do not take care of pedestrians. They take care, but in fact they are on the lookout for pedestrians. As soon as a driver notices a pedestrian step off the pavement, that is, he steps out of the footpath and reaches the road, he regards him as a fair game. He takes aim and accelerates. That is, he comes moving very fast towards the pedestrian. So now let us see what happens after that. Now the driver is seeing a pedestrian, he is coming fast towards him, and the pedestrian has to jump, leap and run for dear life. As soon as the pedestrian, the person who is walking, he see the car coming fast, the car is coming very fast, what he has to do? He immediately has to jump, leap and run for his life. Okay, because a car is coming very fast, coming to hit him. So what he has to do? He has to jump, leap and run for his life. He does not resent this in the least. That is, this driver does not feel bad for doing like this. He does not resent means he does not feel bad. Usually if you do something wrong, you should feel bad, but the driver does not feel bad. And the driver and pedestrian is like these, both driver and pedestrian, they both are like hunter and prey. Okay, hunter and the animal whom he is trying to hunt. Driver is the hunter and pedestrian is the prey. That is, he is trying to hunt this pedestrian. The hunter and the prey smile amicably at each other. They both smile very friendly at each other. They look at each other, smile and go. I win today, you will win tomorrow. So when the pedestrian jump, leap and run for his life, the driver looks at him and smiles. And after smiling, He is thinking in his mind, okay, I win today, you will win tomorrow. Fair enough. That is how it should be. Today you will win, tomorrow I will win. That is how it should be. So that is how a pedestrian and a driver behaves in Brazil. That is what the author is telling. So now let us move on. The war between drivers themselves is murderous. Now we saw the problem of a driver with the person walking, that is a pedestrian. Now then is another problem is war between drivers. Okay, there is a problem between drivers. The war between drivers themselves is murderous, that is very dangerous, the war between the drivers. But good tempered, that is okay, both are with good temper, not irritated. They cut in, sometimes the two cars cut in, one comes in between the other. Okay, sometimes they overtake on both sides, any side they come and overtake. They force you to brake violently, force to brake violently. Suddenly they come in front of you and you have to brake violently and commit all the most heinous crimes of the road. And they make you do all the most heinous crimes, that is wicked crimes of the road, all the problems they create on the road. So the war between drivers is murderous but good tempered. They cut in, they come in front of you suddenly, they overtake on both sides, they force you to brake violently, they commit all the heinous or wicked crimes on off the road, and 20 times every hour. Okay, they make you do all these 20 times every hour, that is continuously they do all these things on the road, but they smile at you the same time. So there is no anger between them. Whatever they do, there is no anger. Finally, after doing all these mistakes, what they do? They smile at you. They smile at you the same time. There is no anger, no hostility, no mad hooting. That is, there is no anger. There is no hostility. That is, there is no unfriendliness at all. Okay, hostility means unfriendly behavior, and they are smiling at you. They are not angry. And there is no mad hooting. That is, no mad hooting. They don't howl at you. They don't shout at you. Okay, there is no shouting. So there is always a friendly behavior, but they do all these kind of dangerous, murderous things on the road. So that is what the author has to say here. Now, afterwards, let us see what the author is saying. The Avenida Presidente Vargas is the worst place of all. So all together Brazil is a problem regarding traffic. In that, one of the worst place is Avenida Presidente Vargas. Okay, this is the worst place of all the places. You stand here trying to cross the road. So here crossing the road is a big problem. So imagine you are standing there to cross the road and contemplating the truly fascinating problem. Contemplating means you look thoughtfully on the problem. That is, you are thinking now what to do. You are thinking about the problem. And how can crawling traffic proceed at such terrifying speed? So what you are thinking is the traffic is crawling. That means there are too much vehicles there. But you are thinking that how can such a lot of vehicles move at such terrifying speed? The speed is still very terrifying. Okay, the speed is still very high. So the worst place is Avenida Presidente Vargas. There, imagine that you stand there trying to cross the road and contemplating the truly fascinating problem. You are thinking of that fascinating problem. That is, how can crawling traffic proceed at such terrifying speed? Okay, how can such crawling traffic, how can so many vehicles together go at such terrifying speed? As hour after hour passes without a ray of hope, and on a ray of hope, an auspicious crossing, you may witness a scene something like this. So hour after hour passes, you are standing there for long hours. Hour after hour passes, that is, time goes on, and still you are standing there not able to cross the road without a ray of hope. That is, without hope you are standing there, you are not able to cross the road. Without hope you are standing there, without a ray of hope of an auspicious crossing, you are not getting a favorable time to cross the road. That time you witness a scene, you are seeing something. So what are you seeing? Something like this. A man on your side of the Avenida Vargas suddenly catches sight of a friend on his other side. So now there is a man who is standing on your side, man on your side of Avenida Presidente Vargas. There is one man standing there. He catches a sight of a friend of his on the other side. So he saw one of his friend on the other side of the road. So he, this man, see a friend on the other side of the road. So he is on this side and friend is on the other side. And what does he on the other side, and starts waving at him. So this man starts waving at him, showing his hands and calling him, waving at him, at the same time looking completely mystified. He's waving at him, but his expression is, he is mystified. That is, he is surprised or confused, or you can say puzzled. He is shocked. Why? And he is asking to his friend, this man is asking to his friend on the other side, how on the earth did you get over there? He shouts across, trying to make himself heard about the traffic. So this man is asking to his friend, how did you get onto the other side? How on the earth did you get over there? That is, it is not at all possible to go to the other side. How did you reach the other side? It is the other fellow's turn to be surprised by this naive question. So now this friend is looking very surprised at this question. At this naive question means like an innocent question. He is surprised by this naive or innocent question. And he yells back, how? I was born on this side. See, you are asking me how I reached this side. And he is telling that, how? I was born on this side. Born on this side, that means I was born on this side, that is why I am here, and it is not that I came crossing from that side to this side. So it shows that it is not at all possible to cross the road in Brazil, or especially Avenida Presidente Vargas. So he is telling that I was born on this side, it is not that I came from the other side to this side. So this is how George Mikes end the chapter. So how on the earth did you get over there? He shouts across, trying to make himself heard about the traffic. It is the other fellow's turn to be surprised by this naive question. He yells back, how? I was born on this side. So this is how George Mike describes the traffic of Brazil. So I hope you are very clear with this chapter. The first part deals with Japanese manners, and second part deals with traffic in Brazil. So George Mikes use a very sarcastic way to explain both these concepts. So if you have any doubt regarding this chapter, you can ask in the comment section. And also don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Your likes and shares will be of a great encouragement for me to make more and more videos. So I hope to see you all soon in the coming video. Thank you for watching.